श्रीमान वेंकटनाथार्य कवितार्किक केसरी वेदांताचार्य वर्यो में सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि नमो नारायण। लेट्स कंटिन्यू टू एंजॉय अवर आचार्य सार्वभौमन श्रीमन निगमांत महादेशिकन्स हयग्रीव स्तोत्रम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू enjoy the anubhavam of Desikan in the seventh verse. The seventh verse goes as follows: dakshinyaramya girishasya murtihi devi saroja sana dharma patni vyasadayopi vyapadeshya vachah spuranti sarve tava shakti leshaihi. In the last verses he said, even the Vedas and Upanishads, the Veda Vedantams, are struggling to praise you. And here in this verse, he says, the so-called, the chief of jnanis, the goddess of learning, and the Kailashanathan, Dakshinamurti, and the sages like Vyasa, Vasishta, Shuka, Parasara, all of them, they all, how they are blessed with the right jnana, Swami mentions here. He says, the Kailashanathan, Girishan, known as Dakshinamurti, the goddess of learning, Sarojasana Dharmapatni, Brahmadevan's spouse, with the name of Saraswati, who is seated on the white lotus as her abode, Saroja Asana Dharmapatni. Even sage Vyasa and other famous sages for their powers of divine vak amritam, all of them derive their power of speech, the jnanam, because from a mere fragment, iota of the power of Adi Vidyamurti, Lord Hayagrivan, whichever deity in this world as a reputation of granting the word power. We say, you pray to Saraswati, you will get jnana, you will get good marks, you will pass your exam, Saraswati, because she is goddess of learning. They say, you pray to Rudra, Dakshinamurti, you will get jnana, you will get the right knowledge. They say, Valmiki, Vyasa, Parasara, they are all great sages who will bless you with the jnana, they say in the world. But they have all admittedly attained that kind of power, jnana, of granting something to the devotees like us who seek from them, because they secured, they themselves, they means Dakshinamurti, Saraswati, Vyasa and others, sages, they secure an iota, a fraction, a fragment of the power of the grace of Sri Hayagriva. So they say, come on, worship the goddess of learning, you will stand to benefit. But the human tendency, especially when proper spiritual jnanam is a rarity as it is today, by they say they resort to them, resort to this, resort to Saraswati, all that they say. Dakshinamurti, Saraswati, various sages, thinkers, holy poets, they all have acquired their mastery in the word power, in the literature, by Lord Hayagriva's grace. And that too, a speck of it, a fraction of it. If that's the case, what can we not achieve by worshipping Hayagriva himself? And if he blesses us with that fraction, we ourselves would be shining with the extreme concentration. And here, Swami, in the commentator, they write so beautifully. Here, they say, from Bhagavad Gita 10.41, Yat yat bhuti matsatvam shrimadurjitamevava tat tat devavagachatvam mama tejosam sasambhavam mama tejom sasambhavam. Whatever in this prapancham is shining with some aishwaryam, all because of a fraction of my tejas. Get to know, Arjuna. Whatever Gita, Krishna himself says, which essentially is this slokam. Vyasadayopi vyapadeshcha vacha spuranti sarve tava shakti leshaihi. Tava shakti, your power, leshaihi, one fraction, one fragmentation of that. And Hayagrivan is sarva vedatmako vidvan. Veda vedanta paragas paragaha sarva sastra krit. He is sarva vagishwareshwaran. So he is the lord of all gods of learning. His mere kataksham is enough for vishesha jnanam. Swami Desikan's inspiration for this slokam perhaps comes from one of the slokams of Sri Hayagriva Prapatti. Sri Sadagopanmama writes, Vijnana Dhana Pratita Jagatyam Vyasadayo Vagapi Dakshinasa Yadvikshanamsa Ahita Vaibhavastam Devam Hayagriva Maham Prapadhye. This slokam recognizes that Lord Hayagrivan, celebrated for his Vidya Dhanam, blesses us, the great rishis like Vyasa, by his Vikshana Vaibhavam, the power of Kataksham alone. And that's what is described by Swami in this verse. So here he says, the Dakshinamurti owes his power to Nikila Samasya Harana Naipunyam, expertise in the removal of all doubts about Tattvams from his Acharyan, Lord Hayagrivan. And he goes on to instruct the four great rishis and others. Thirumayishi Alvar mentions, Ala Nidarki Araneriye Nalvarki Melai Uhattu Uraitavan Mei Tavaton. Under the banyan tree sat this Mahapurushan, Rudran, of great tapas, and he instructed the four eminent sages about the wonderful Tattvartams through the medium of silence. How did he get that power? From his Acharyan, Lord Hayagrivan. And he instructs the great rishis. Shakti lesam, the power that comes from the shakti lesam, the fraction of the power from Hayagrivan. And the second one is Saraswati, Devi Sarojasana Dharmapatni. She is the spouse of Chaturmukha Brahma, seated on the red lotus flower arising out of the navel of the Lord. She is Pustaka Dharini, one who has the Pustakam and has a Japamalai on the other hand, reciting perhaps Sri Hayagriva Mantram. She is seated on the white lotus like her Acharya. And in fact, Brahma himself tells, and Manishada Pratishtam Tvam Agamachashwati Samaha, So this Saraswati is Dharmapatni. Dharmapatni who listens to the Bharta Brahma. And based on Brahma's words, she grants. So when Brahma blessed Valmiki, Machanda Devate Brahman Pravritteyam Saraswati. Based on my ishtam, my nod, my approval, Saraswati will now occupy your walk. Brahma tells sage Valmiki. Thus, Saraswati blesses someone based on Chaturmukha Brahma's approval. So, Dharmapatni. Vyapadeshya vachaha. Vyasadayopi Vyapadeshya vachaha. Vyasa, Parasara and Valmiki, all these sages. Spuranti. Spuranti. Bhagavan, when you compare Bhagavan's Jnana Prakasham, his lustrous knowledge, the other like Rudran, Saraswati, Veda Vyasa, all of them are like the fly, Minmini Puchi. And compared to the sun's brightness, they are nowhere. And that is what is talked about here. This is only temporary jnanam, whereas his is eternal and his is grand. कवितार्किकसिंहाय कल्याणगुणशालिने श्रीमते वेंकटेशाय वेदांत गुरवे नमः. नमो नारायण. अड़िया.